Yesterday's reopening of the National Assembly was shadowed by looming impeachment motions, one against the President and another one against devolution Cabinet Secretary Ann Waiguru. Though the two impeachment motions are yet to be filed with the office of the Speaker, it is the intention to remove CS Waiguru as being fronted by Nandi Hills MP Alfred Keter, a member of the URP party that has alarmed Jubilee's leadership in both houses.
Alfred Keter is speaking for moles. He has become a mole of the Code Coalition. He speaks for some very dark forces. He speaks for some people who want to create a diversionary tactics.
Our decision to be in Jubilee is final. We made that decision a long time ago, and we have said we are going to support the President 2017, and we are going to support the Deputy President 2022.
National Assembly Majority Leader Aden Duale and Senate's Deputy Majority Leader Charles Keter insist the ruling coalition is intact and no party is interested in ousting the devolution CS. They claim Alfred Keter is working for the opposition and will not get the support of any member allied to the Jubilee team.
We are ready for that. Because Alfred Keter, we know after he finishes the business, he'll come back to us. He's just doing some business.
He has his own democratic right, and we wish him all the best, as explained by Duale, that the motion is planning. We have nothing to do with it.
Alfred Keter is basing his motion on the reported loss of 792 million shillings at the National Youth Service.
You cannot investigate yourself and report back to us that, oh, I had reported that earlier on that there were no money lost, but I've realized there is 791 million lost. But I want to tell Kenyans that the money that was misappropriated in, and was scandaled in National Youth Service is more than what was declared.
The lawmaker vowed to get 117 MPs to append their signatures for the motion to reach the floor of the House.
They are raising a concern, and we know even some members of parliament, some politicians, have benefited from that scandal. So we are not surprised when they come here and defend themselves. Oh, there is nothing like that. It is against government. They are doing double. They are giving. That is a double standard.
Kevin Washira, Channel One News.